What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you some really cool tips for loading certain elements inside of your model. So first I'm just going to be showing you how to load in families from the official Autodesk libraries from online, so you don't have to have them on your computer. That's one thing, but also the kind of the dialogue and the search functions for these, for searching and browsing through the families, it's much better than kind of the more conventional or the old method, I guess you can say. So I think it's a really powerful feature. After that, I'm going to be showing you how to reuse some of your previous projects by loading them into your current projects as groups. So this gives you some really cool functionality, and it's super simple to do. And finally, I'm going to be showing you how to reuse schedules from existing projects into your current project. So you can actually find a project that has a schedule that you need, and you just click on that, and it's going to load that schedule into your active project, which will save you a lot of time for creating that schedule. Now, before we jump into all of that, I would just quickly like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to include a link just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. If you're serious about learning Revit and becoming really good at it, that's definitely the best place to go. I have over 130 hours of content, ranging from beginner to intermediate to advanced level topics. I cover a wide range of topics, and I go through everything step by step in depth. So there, I would just like to encourage you to check that out if you want to learn Revit. And also there you can find my Revit customized templates, you can find my high quality Revit families, and you can find a plugin which you might find interesting. And finally, one more thing, I would just like to ask you to like this video and also make sure to subscribe. Not only does it help you not miss any of my future videos, but also it makes the alpaca happy, and we want to make the alpaca happy, so make sure to do it. Okay, so now, without any further ado, let's jump into Revit, and here we are. And before we start, make sure that you're using the latest version of Revit. Some of these features are only available with the latest version, so just keep that in mind. I'm using Revit 2022, so that's the current latest version. So now, let's go here to Models, let's go to New. For the template file, I'm just going to be using the architectural template, just the basic one. And now let's get started. So how do you load in families from the web? So what you want to do is go to the Insert tab, and here by clicking on Load Family, it just brings you to your regular libraries, and then you can search for your families and so on. It's pretty basic and it doesn't work that well, and it's not intuitive. However, you have this load Autodesk family, a fancy button with a little cloud icon indicating that the families are on the cloud. So when we just click on that, you can see that here you can search for families. Now I've been playing around here a little bit, so let's get rid of this search. Okay, so here first you can set up your language and your region, so which one you want to use. Here you can, let's close that up, here you can set up the toggle view type. So by default it's going to be set up like this, where you get these little thumbnails, and I think this is the best option because you can see what the families look like, and this is usually what I like to see. And then on this side here, we have kind of a browse function. So first we can select the category, so I can say, okay, do I want to search for furniture perhaps? So I can go to furniture, and then it lists it out, and then here you can go to storage, for example, and search for things. You can always go back by going here or by clicking here, just go back. In addition to that, you can search for things. So if you want a table, you just search for table, and it brings up all of the available tables. So I like this chair table, reminds me of school. These tables are horrible, and when you load them in, when you go to architecture component, you can just place it there, and there we go, we have this horrible chair table thing on our screen and in our model. So there you go, it's super simple, it's super easy, and it's a really good intuitive way of browsing through your categories and through your families. Now, of course, you can always keep this at any so any category, and then you can just, instead of searching by category, you can just type something in. So if I say light and hit enter, here are all of the lights. So I can just select the light, load that in, and then next to this desk, we can place our light. There we go. Now we have a little skull thing going on here. Anyways, so that's how you load in these families from the web. So moving forward, let's now take a look at how to load in previous projects as groups. So it's called load as group. So you just click on that and it's going to open up your file browser. So I'm just going to quickly search for my files. And here you can see I'm just going to be using the bedroom file. So this is like a hotel bedroom. And let's say I want to use it on this project, but I don't want to link it. I just want to use it as a group because it's going to give me some functionality that I like to see. So I can just click there, hit open, and it's going to load that in. Okay. There we go. It's loaded in. Now you might be thinking, well, where is it? Well, when you load in your projects as groups, they're going to appear with the groups. So where are the groups? They are with all of your other families, views, and so on, and that is here on the project browser. So you go to your project browser, you scroll all the way down to, here we go, families, and here are the groups. So you expand the groups node, and here we have the model node, so we expand that as well, and here we have our bedroom group. And you can just drag it out, place it, and there we go. So this is that group. If I go to the 3D view, there we go. So we have a little hotel bedroom, and then you can use this for your project. I can just go here to copy, and then I can copy this multiple times to have multiple hotel rooms. And then if I don't like the fact that here we have this wall, I can just remove it from a group and delete it. So now we don't have overlapping walls, we just have one wall. I have a whole video on groups, so check it out if you're interested. Just search for Balkan Architect Revit groups. Anyways, so that's how you load in your projects as groups. Now, let's say that we want a room schedule for our hotel. So how do we do that? Well, we can go here and create a new schedule, but that's going to take forever. The easier way is to go here to insert from file. So if I expand this, as you can see, you can insert either through 2D elements, which is also really cool because you can load in existing details. So if you've used the details on one project, you can just load them in by clicking on this. Or you can insert views. So I really like this because I like to load in some schedules. Or as you can see here, you can load in sheets or even drafting views. So let's click on this, wait for a few moments. And now, again, you have to specify the file from which you want to use that schedule. And here we go. So I want to use this office building project because I have some really cool schedules there. I can just open that up, and it's going to upgrade the model. It's going to wait for a few moments just to kind of run through the whole process, and then it's going to bring up a dialogue where we're going to specify which schedule or which view we might want to include here. Here we can see we have some errors. That's okay, it still works. And then, as you can see, we can even load in this cool kind of 3D section rendering that I've done like for a previous video, but I don't want that now. I want my my room schedule. So let's open that one up. So let's select that, click OK, and now here we have a room schedule. Obviously it's empty because we don't have any rooms here, but if I were to go just to the architecture tab, go to room, and then place some rooms here just like that, and then let's just quickly give them some names. There we go, that was quick. And now if I go back to the room schedule, as you can see here, I have all of those rooms. We have some calculation, we have the perimeter, the area, the level, and so on. So it was a really quick way of creating a schedule because, well, we did didn't even have to create it. We just kind of borrowed it from a previous video, so or previous project. So anyways, I hope you have enjoyed this video. I hope you have learned something new, and I hope you find this useful. If you want all of my Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page. So I'm going to include that just below this video in the description. If you're interested, please check it out. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.